Racing to the 2024 Kentucky Oaks, and this time we go to the Big Apple. It is part of a big card on Saturday in New York. It's going to be Gotham Day in the Big Apple, but we've also got a race for the 2-3-year-old fillies going 1 mile on the dirt. It is going to be the Busher Stakes. Of course, this is now into the championship season at the Kentucky Oaks level. So the winner of this race pretty much gets a spot, and there's only 14 spots in that Kentucky Oaks field. It did draw a field of a 7, and they're going to go 1 mile, race number 7 on Saturday. Of course, stakes action does include the Tom Fool, and we've already got a preview of the Gotham Stakes already up on the channel. But I thought this was one of the more interesting races of the weekend. I think you really can make a case for 5-6 horses in this 7-horse field. And I do think, you know, the betting is going to be pretty wide open. You know, Jody's Pride comes in off that second place finish in the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies. But that race kind of came back a little bit on the slow side for a buyer speed figure. Let's take a look at this 7-horse field, starting off with number 1, a winner last time out. That was in a maiden special weight race for the Banker Boys. Regulatory Risk took a little bit to break his maiden, did it in career start number 3, but she faced a couple of good horses in her first two races, West Sunset and Tarifa. Meanwhile, Jin Jin, a winner of the Busanda Stakes, but was pressured all the way to the wire that time by Princess Mayfair. Sicilian Princess, this is a horse making her second lifetime start. She's by Justify, out of a Street Cry mare. Nice pedigree. One start, 1 second place finish. That was at Turfway Park on the synthetic. I could see her improving here on the stretch out to 1 mile for Sicilian Princess. Meanwhile, Princess Mayfair, blinkers off this time, second last time out to Gin for Gin. Before that, ran second to Jayhawk, did pick up a win at Woodbine, so she's another one with synthetic experience. Aoife's Magic, 4 for 4 at Parks. Buyer speed figures are slow, but she's slowly improving, a 54 to a 64, then last time out, kind of a sloppy track. I'm not so sure that speed figure is accurate on Aoife's Magic on that sloppy surface. And then Jody's Pride, big win in the Matron Stakes, but that was originally scheduled for the turf. She won her first time out by 10, and then she ran second in the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies. That was at 18 to 1. And overall, this is a very strong Busher field. Rounding out the field is Carmelina. 6 starts, 4 wins. She's a 3-time stakes winner. She's got some speed. She's won her last two races. Goes for the hat trick here in the Busher Stakes. Again, 7 horses, pretty evenly matched. You've got some recent winners. You've got multiple stakes winners in Carmelina, moving up in class from Laurel Park, and then also the Princess of Parks in Aoife's Magic. But any way you could go in this race, overall my top contenders, I think on the betting board, going to be Jody's Pride, Regulatory Risk, Princess Mayfair, and Jin Jin. Let's take a look at the race replays and how they got here to this race. Starting off with Jody's Pride. Again, she won her debut by 10 lengths, but we're going to take you back to the Matron Stakes. She draws off in this race. It was scheduled for the turf. It ended up being on the dirt, but Jody's Pride, a nice win here before running second in the Juvenile Fillies. We move now to Jin Jin. Last time out, Busher Stakes. She goes all the way to the wire, pressured all the way to the wire by Princess Mayfair. She won the Busanda, has a route pedigree, and she can come off the pace if need be, and there is some speed in this race. Carmelina, a 3-time stakes winner. Let's take you back to her wire-to-wire effort last time out. This was at Laurel Park. Goes wire to wire, picks up a stakes victory. She also had a stakes win at Colonial Downs. And Carmelina, 4 for 6 lifetime, shipping in to Aqueduct. Aoife's Magic, a winner last time out at Parks. Here she is, kind of a sloppy, muddy surface, very slow surface that day. But Aoife's Magic picks up the win. She's now 4 for 4 and a couple of stakes wins on the resume for Aoife's Magic. But she does have to face better horses here in this race. As I mentioned, a very competitive Busher Stakes. You can go different ways. Let's take a look at the pace analysis. I think Aoife's Magic probably going to be on the lead. Regulatory Risk off that layoff, but she's shown speed and faced good horses in all of her efforts. But you could also make the case that Carmelina, with that seventh post position, could go to the lead. Now, the big pressers going to be Princess Mayfair with those blinkers off and Jody's Pride. Jody's Pride did show that she could come off the pace last time out in the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies. Mid-pack, I'm going to go with Sicilian Princess, but she's only got that one race, and she is stretching out from 6.5 furlongs to 1 mile. And the closer, I think Jin Jin, probably going to come off the pace here in the Busher Stakes. But again, with lightly raced horses and horses coming from different tracks and different class levels, I'm not sure who's going to be on the lead, but I'm going to go with Aoife's Magic as your most likely pace setter. The big questions when you're handicapping this Busher Stakes, again, lots of shippers, different tracks to compare. Jody's Pride off the layoff, but a big win in New York last year. Regulatory Risk faced two good horses, Tarifa, who won last week at the fairgrounds, a couple weeks ago at the fairgrounds. Then you've got Aoife's Magic, 4-for-4 at Parks, but she's got to go up in class. And Sicilian Princess on the stretch out by Justify, a chance to maybe improve in her second lifetime start. On paper, let's take a look at the buyer speed figures. Fastest buyer speed figure is Jody's Pride, that's 79 in the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies. But Carmelina right there with a 75, Sicilian Princess a 74, and then even Princess Mayfair and Jin Jin right there on the buyer speed figures. Now, with that in mind, these horses are improving. Fillies start really getting good in February and March of their three-year-old season. I think somebody's going to step up, and my top selection in the Busher Stakes is going to be Regulatory Risk. I know she's slowest on paper. I like the clashes she's faced in West Sunset and Tarifa. I think she can come just off the pace in this race. I'm going to play her in exactas over Jin Jin, Princess Mayfair, and Jody's Pride. You know, Jody's Pride going to be a short price. She's got the two big wins, but she's coming off the layoff, and that Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies, we'll see if that's a live race. And you can also definitely make the case for Aoife's Magic, 4-for-4. I think those buyer speed figures probably a little better than the numbers suggest. So lots of ways you can go here in the Busher Stakes. The road to the 150th Kentucky Derby continues. We've got the Fountain of Youth, the Devona Dale, and the John Battaglia. Those previews are already up on the channel. Fountain of Youth Saturday going to be the comeback of Dornock. Of course, he won the Remsen Stakes and Locked, the winner of the Grade 1 Breeders' Futurity. You can watch that on the channel. Also, the Devona Dale preview is up. We'll see how the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies winner does in that race. Triple Crown Prospectus, make sure to subscribe. Every Monday, I write 2,000 words. I have a top 12 rankings for the Derby, Oaks notes, and it's free to subscribe. Sign up below in the description. My Saturday tip sheet will be out this week. It's called the Saturday Notebook. Subscribe to that. And who do you like in the Busher Stakes for 2024? Leave a comment. Dwayne Lucas always says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.